Hello students, so today we are going to do the first poem from your Hornbill book and the poem is A Photograph. Shirley Tolson is the poetess of this poem and this is a beautiful poem in which the poetess is remembering her mother and some memories related to her mother. Alright, so let us start with the poem. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. Each one holding one of my mother's hands and she the big girl, some 12 years or so. Now, here in these lines, the poetess is looking at a photograph. Cardboard here means refers to a photograph, a picture, okay? And in that picture, there are three girls and all three of them are paddling, means are walking on the beach, okay? Are paddling, they are walking on the beach, okay? And all three of them are holding hands with each other and there's a girl in the middle and that girl is the mother of the poetess and she is the oldest among the three and she is 12 years of age that time when this picture was taken. So all these things, the poetess is looking at a picture and she's remembering her mother and the memories related to that picture. Alright. So in that picture, her mother was 12 years old. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. Now, when this picture, who took this picture that time? Their uncle took that picture. Okay. And they were smiling that time looking in the camera. And while that picture was taken, wind was blowing, which made their hair come in front of their face. And that hair was also captured. And between those hairs, their smiles are also captured. Okay. So that is why the poetesses say that even behind those hairs, she could see the smiles on their face. Okay. When their uncle took the photograph. A sweet face, okay, and looking at the face, all the three faces, okay, the poetess says that my mother had such a sweet face when she was 12 years old, when she was enjoying her vacation on the beach along with her cousins and when this picture was taken. My mother's, that was before I was born. And this picture was taken when she was 12 years old. That means when the poetess's mother was 12 years old. And that time the poetess was not born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Now this is important. Why? Transient means something which is not permanent, something which is subjected to change. Okay, so the poetess is saying that sea where this picture was taken, where this picture of my mother and her cousins were taken, that sea has not changed. Okay, that sea has changed less. That means that sea haven't changed at all. But the people in that picture, that means the poetess's mother and her cousins, obviously they have changed. They have not remained permanently like that in that picture. Okay, they have changed, they have grown up, they have been married, they have given birth to children and they have even passed away. So that means this shows that the sea is something which is permanent, which is not subjected to change. On the other hand, humans are subjected to change. We are not permanent. We are going to die one day. We are going to grow. We are going to get older. And then one day we are going to die. So that is the relationship between the transient feet, which keeps on changing, which is not permanent, and the sea, which haven't changed and which has remained the same through so many years. Okay, some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. Okay, now in these lines, the poetess is remembering her mother when she looked at the picture. Okay. When the mother herself looked at that picture of her along with the two cousins that was taken on the beach. Okay, when she looked at that picture, she would say, the poetess is remembering this, she would say, see Betty and Dolly. That means the name of the cousins, the name of the two cousins which were there in the picture. Okay, their name was Betty and Dolly. And she used to say, the poetess is also remembering that her mother used to say, our parents used to dress us to go to the beach. See, and look how they dressed us for the beach. They here refers to the parents of the poetess's mother. Okay, when they were going to the beach, the parents dressed them properly and they sent them on the beach, and there that photograph was taken, which the poetess is talking about. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter, both weary with the labored ease of loss. And now the poetess is saying that for her, okay, for her, that smile and that beach holiday, okay, was the mother's past, which was taken when she was 12 years of age. That was a past for my mother, but for me, what is my past? My mother's laughter is my past. Okay, why? Because my mother is no more, she has died, she has passed away, and that is why her laughter and herself has become a memory for me. Okay, the poetess is saying, both weary means very disappointed, very saddened, very sorrowful. Okay, so both of these is very disappointing, but with a labored ease of loss. That means labored ease of loss means we have to move on in life. We have to accept the loss that we have lost in our life. Okay, and that is why we have to move on, we have to accept the truth, and we have to move on. So that is why the poet is saying, although this is very disappointing, very sorrowful for me and my mother that we both have passed, which we cannot get back, but this is a labored ease of loss. That means we have to accept this loss and we have to move on in our life. Now she's been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. Now here, as many years as that girl lived refers to as many years that girl lived. That means the picture when that was taken of her mother when, on the beach holiday, that time she was 12 years old. And now it has been 12 years that the poetess's mother has passed away. That is why as many years as the girl lived has been mentioned here. And of this circumstance there is nothing to say at all, and about this I don't have anything to say, okay, because death has silenced us, okay, because death has silenced the poetess's mother, okay, which has also left her or the poetess speechless. That is why she doesn't have anything to say anymore. It's silence silences. That means death, because of death my mother is silent, and because of the death of her mother and because of her passing away, I have nothing to say. I am speechless because of that. Okay, so this poem describes the transient or the impermanent nature of human existence on this earth. Okay, and just like everything else on this earth, we are subjected to go someday, we are going to die someday. Okay, like a thing gets like broken or something, we as humans, we are going to grow older, and one day a time will come when we will have to say goodbye to this world, and one day we will die. And it is these photographs that we take every day, okay, like when we take photographs, we are just capturing the moments, we are just making memories. So that is the importance of the photographs. When we will go one day, when we will pass away, at least like the people after us, the generation after us, they will remember us. They will relive that moment seeing those photographs. Even for us, when we see a photograph of our childhood, we again go back to that time when that picture was taken, and we can still relive that moment, right? So that is the importance of the picture and the poem. A poem is also like stressing us on living the life cheerfully, because we are going to one day, and we are going to count on only on those days when we had fun, when we enjoyed our life. We are not going to remember the sad memories or the sad things that happened in our life, but we are going to count on the cheerful days. So that is why it is important that we understand that we are not permanent on this earth. We are going to die one day, and that is why it is important to enjoy life, and that is why it is important to make memories. Okay, so that was a beautiful poem again. I hope all of you have understood. Thank you, students.